Thank you. On the count of three, could you guys give me something that you want to see a show about? One, two, three.
Tadpole.
Thank you.
We know tadpoles. They're those little squiggly things that turn into frogs, and you catch them when you're in second grade and raise them in a jar, except half the time they end up just dying in the jar. There's no oxygen.
You know, what got me out of seventh grade biology frog dissection? Mononucleosis. Which is especially great when you haven't smooched anyone yet. How'd you get it?
I don't know.
You can be like, I'm thinking of those books that like a person was changing from a human into like some sort
animorphs.
Of animorphs or something. That is probably just some like tadpoles made sexy. I didn't read the books.
At the beginning of time, there was an a bacteria, and then it grows. Next is a swan-like creature, and then after it, it transforms into a monkey. And then afterwards, it transforms into a Neanderthal, or some other kind of Homo species. And then finally, you have college students walking about a campus.
There it is.
No, that's gross. I'm not going in the closet with Gretchen. I'm not doing it. I'm going back upstairs. I'm going to hang out with your parents. I'm not doing it.
It's called 7 minutes in heaven. Don't be a jerk.
That's gross. You have cooties. You know it.
Come on. Please, just what about just 5 minutes? 5 minutes in heaven.
I didn't start reading chapter books until second grade, and now people tell me that's not good. But I think that I developed okay, and thank you. And I don't use reading a lot for my job as an engineer, so.
What was your first chapter book? What was your first chapter book?
I think Treasure Island.
Okay.
Thank you.
Tadpole! Well, Jonathan, are you going to be teacher's helper and help me put away the textbooks or not? Come on.
Listen, I don't usually do this.
Okay.
I'm kind of known as the bad boy, the sexy boy around school.
Yeah, they don't give attention to the ugly smart kids.
Don't you think I know that, man? Man, it's like the world's trying to bring me down because I'm so hot. I feel like I feel like I could do anything, soar anywhere. Go be a model in Latvia.
Oh, yeah.
But here I am, being in detention with this dude. Ah.
Pull up a seat, Jonathan. let's talk about the face of the world. I used to be sexy before I turned 54.
What? How are you not dead?
Well, I don't eat a lot of meat products. Well, let's talk a little bit about being a sexy badass.
All right, that's my expertise.
If you can believe it, it was mine, too.
That's just a picture of David Hasselhoff.
You'd think that, wouldn't you? Look at the thumbprint in the corner. I was a sexy badass.
You have such thick ridges in your thumb.
See it in space.
Yeah.
Now, you see, the difference was that, I eventually had to come up with a life plan when I turned ugly. See, I was modeling for Teen Vogue.
What?
Yeah. Modeling for Teen Vogue, Newsweek, sometimes the cover of New York Times, and they didn't have a sob story. And then it happened.
What happened, Mr. Barber?
Well, turned a new age, got a little older, a little thicker around the middle. I had to go to college. To get a teaching license.
Sounds like the worst.
Had to pass a teaching exam, and now here I am teaching seventh graders like you. Seventh graders with one chin hair and suddenly think you're a sexy man.
Truth.
Okay. Which one of us is going to read the truth that we wrote down on our paper? Because mine is a doozy.
Okay, Cindy, you go first.
You guys, the truth or dare, you're supposed to ask me a question, and you always do this. You make the game about you. I've never got to do a truth or a dare.
You know the way we play is we write down stuff that we want to share about ourselves on the paper, and we ask you what you want to hear. From whom?
Listen,
from you, Elizabeth.
Mom's gonna be home in an hour, so
I said
truth from Elizabeth.
Okay, are you ready? Mine is sometimes. Stop it. When I get home, and neither of you are around, sometimes I will put on Mom's bathing suit, one piece that has the boobs built in, and I'll walk like this down the hallway and say, "No, Stuart, I don't want you to be around anymore."
Go ahead and try to beat that, Allison.
True.
Okay. I wish you would call Dad instead of Stuart. Sometimes when Mom's not home, I go into her closet and I try on her wedding dress, and then I look up the vows that she and Dad said at their wedding, and I recite them to myself in the mirror in the hopes that one day I'll find a dad or a husband as good as him.
I've never gotten a turn before.
Well, the youngest gets a turn sometimes.
And now's your chance. We need to fill some
awkward silence. Yeah. Wow. Okay, well, I didn't prepare anything, but I guess we're on a roll with what we do when no one's home. When no one's home, I go through all your stuff. When no one's home, I just like go through all your stuff.
But like what stuff?
Like all your stuff. Like your underwear drawer.
Ew.
Like the box in your closet.
What?
Yeah.
No.
The box.
Not the box. The box of the pictures where you have cut Dad's face out of the wedding photo and
not
just
the box.
Pasted boys from magazines into the place of his face.
I'm sorry.
And say, "Mommy will love you." That box? We know that box.
I'm sorry that our father is the best man we will ever know, okay?
Girls, has anyone seen my One Piece?
Professor, I can't believe what I'm seeing. You have to look at this.
Dear God, it's spawning.
It's alive! There's millions of them!
They are reproducing and reproducing and reproducing. We need to destroy them.
At this rate, they'll have filled this room by tomorrow morning. Oh God, it's already overtaking the bench!
I saw a movie about this and they were in space and all of them died, and then Jake Gyllenhaal tried to save them by taking them out into space,
yes.
But he fucked it up!
But we're not Jake Gyllenhaal! Jake Gyllenhaal can fuck it up, but...
What chance do we have?
At a publicly funded university house.
No, this is Penn State. This isn't something in the Ivy Leagues.
I'm just saying. We do really well with what we have.
We try. But listen, we can't drop
it. Yes. Right. It's overtaking the corner now.
Listen. I know that I'm the professor in this situation, but I'm old, and I don't know what to do in these types of situations. I don't know how to kill this. You've more recently finished the curriculum. You've read a lot of textbooks much more sooner than me. I've actually not actually read a textbook.
I haven't either. I passed all your classes because we had a shared Google Drive with all of the old tests because you'd never changed them here from...
I can't believe Google let somebody down.
Get away from it!
It's growing again! Do you know that language? I don't know that language!
Oh, I took one semester of Arabic, just for kicks!
Just try and see if it knows Arabic!
Yes! Kundali!
Oh, these lights!
did you dead? Is this one of the...
No, it's talking about the lights. It doesn't like the lights. Hello, hello.
Hi, Trevor.
Hi. I think somehow we're sort of like your original parents.
Professor, I don't think of you that way. I just want to... I admire your work. I think you're very handsome for a 60-year-old.
Just because you don't have to, like, do that type of activity to, like,
Sorry, Trevor.
This was me? Oh, this right here?
Do you want to look at your first home through this
microscope? This microscope, it's good.
That is where you came from.
Hey, are you going to kill us all?
He doesn't know the word kill yet.
Use like any other word.
Taking off your clothes.
There's so many ways. Almost every other way.
In the real world, the way people make money is they make a conscious business decision. They write a business
decision. and this business decision, is that networking?
Ugly, and now I have pretty people putting their heads in through the window telling me I'm mean as well.
Okay, my first.
Inside and outside.
And thank you so much.
My first business decision is to, like, close the window.
Second kid.
I'm gonna do my first act that I've ever done clothed. I'm gonna close the window.
Wow, okay, wow. Maybe that's cool.
I don't know, Cindy. They pretty much just closed the window on us. And I don't even know what we said.
Like your only plan.
The resistance is strong, you guys. We're we're gonna get them.
You just told them they were mean. How's that gonna affect the profits of the school?
We're playing the long game, Timothy, okay?
I'm not a financial wizard.
Well, day three, talking about our decisions.
Let's make a sound decision.
We're not making any money, is what we're not making. Or shints. Money and shench.
That's a kind of money.
Right? Thank you. I'm ugly, but I'm not dumb.
Finally, we're learning.
Stuart? Stuart?
Yes?
Have you seen?
Stop that, you cad.
Oh my god! Your body looks so hot in that one piece.
Thank you.
Oh my god.
I was going to ask you though, have you seen the pearl earrings you got me last year?
The ones I always wear with this one piece bathing suit?
Darling, when you're wearing that, I don't look at the earrings. I mean.
Daddy, I made up a new song.
Oh, awesome. Sweetie.
I'm
my favorite
sorry.
Sweetie.
Can I hear?
Sing the song for Daddy.
Excuse me, Mom, could I have the floor? Tomorrow.
Let me get my phone out.
Okay,
it's not necessary. She said this yesterday.
Mom, could you get your veil for me?
Get her. Do you still have the earrings?
Oh yeah.
Beautiful. Oh my God, beautiful. She's my little star.
Are you gonna put this one on YouTube too, Dad?
Yes.
Okay. Hey, Mom.
Oh, please.
I just want to tell you that there's a box under your bed and you should probably look in it. It's not under
your
bed.
Why do you look so worried, Allison?
No, it's, I don't know. Who cares about the box?
About
tomorrow!
The box that's under this bed? About the box that's under this bed right here?
Yeah, that's just a box of shoes under a bed.
Doesn't sound like a box of shoes.
Well, now I feel weird wearing the veil.
College is an alien boy. Never thought I'd make it.
Hey, heads up!
What?
Whoa, your head just fell right off, dude!
You know, I'm different.
Right on!
What's your name?
Zorg?
Oh, what? That doesn't sound human.
Well, I'm actually not.
Zorg, wait.
No, you probably think I'm a freak.
No! Listen, I tell everybody my name is Trevor, but my name is actually Kong.
Seymour, got a real situation on this college campus.
Why do we have to wear earbuds if we're standing right next to each other?
Because this is the government, Seymour.
All right. Listen, I got an eagle eye on subject 2.
I got Hawkeye on subject 1.
Alright, they're about to go to a frat party.
I see them now.
Oh my god, guys, both of your arms are so strong, and the way they keep detaching and reattaching.
When we walk, our arms also have to move. It's our species.
I got a top secret cable from Washington. Be careful of procreating with the bacterium. Watch out for the woman species.
A crazy idea, guys.
Yeah.
It's not the only thing that grows back.
Oh my god!
That mono, it's positive. How have you had mono 3 times and you've not even kissed anyone?
I don't know, I keep licking stuff.
Oh my god.
Well, I really think your mom should make you stay home from Girl Scouts if that's the case.
Alright.
Oh my god, a mono outbreak. We can't have another mono outbreak. Oh my god.
Who's gonna sell my Thin Mint?
You didn't lick any of the cookies that we already sold to, like, the entire town, did you?
I like Samoas, and I'm allergic to the lemon ones.
Guys, we can't take them back. We're in a budget deficit.
The last time there was a mono outbreak, someone died.
No one died! That officially. Okay, you know, we don't know what happened. happened after they took his body away, okay? Anything could have happened.
I think we do know he was...
Mr. Rickers died.
No!
Yeah.
Guys!
There was a memorial put up in the gym.
Stop admitting to this! You would have got 231 boxes of clean Samoas in order to, you know, pay for his funeral insurance. If we admit to wrongdoing, insurance companies will come after us.
But you can't buy funeral insurance if someone's already dead.
No, we just gotta lean in. We've already done it. We gotta sell all the cookies. Just out of our hands.
Lick some more.
We just gotta lick them all. Just
do it. Lick all of them.
Wait a second!
None of you saw how he died, but I did. You don't know what it's like to die from mono.
Oh, God.
I know, you start convulsing, and then it's almost like you're trying to kiss your own heart.
Did you see her? She's like twitching, right? She's twitching. That was a convulsion! I'm sorry.
All right, so you're in this 401 sexuality class because you're aliens in this college, and regular sexual education just didn't really work for you.
I'm late, but I'm
right here.
It could be mine, though.
It could be mine.
It's mine. Together.
Hello, is this the country of Latvia? I'm here to model.
Oh, Latvia.
Of course it is the country of Latvia.
Sit your sexy ass on the floor and beg for food.
Born here.
Oh, hell yeah! What do we got going on here?
This is very sexy.
This is hot.
Oh, is this a cow I'm supposed to milk?
Touch the cow.
Yes, that cow. Yes.
It's good.
This is not on TV.
Okay, leave Betsy alone.
Betsy, go back.
Truth or dare, Stuart?
Truth.
Allison, come in here, please. Oh, or Elizabeth, the little one. I don't remember what I named you.
Did you say Elizabeth and the little one? Do we?
Hi, little one. Hi, Elizabeth.
Is this your new boyfriend, Stuart? Because I fucking hate him. I wish Dan were here.
Yeah, it's pretty cold that you started dating someone with the same name.
So much like him.
I know. Well, that's because of what is behind my truth card. Do you girls want to see it?
I do, but I don't. I do, but...
Look, it says, on the night of March 31st, at approximately 5 p.m., while you were all in your swim lessons, I took your father, Stuart, not this Stuart, down to the docks. And that's interesting. No one's ever seen him since then.
What?
Yes, I just got left down at the docks here. I'm not dead or anything, just sad.
Hey, don't I get it, buddy? That's what we all come down to the docks for.
I've been here for a long time. My name is Mr. Rickers, and no one knows what happened.
I was once a beautiful model, but then had to be a teacher. And now I live here in the sewer.
Tomorrow. Daddy!
Oh, here we go.
Sweetheart.
What have you been doing down at the docks?
Making some friends.
Hey, Barbs.
Good to see you. I'm a certified teacher if you need schooling.
Your mother, does she talk about me?
She let me wear her wedding dress down to the
her
docks.
Her wedding dress, oh.
So we are aliens, and we will be leading this class on ugliness.
Wow!
Now, the thing you all must understand is that everybody is just a little bit different. And the two of us, probably most of all. And the one thing we would like for you to know is that ugliness is not a condemnation on who you are as a person, but rather something to be celebrated. Mm-hmm. Because ugliness is just another word for different.
I'm so glad we didn't kill it.
I know, Professor.
Those are my parents.